Are you getting what I'm saying? The person can what? Change. Do you know every human being is a work in progress? I hope you know that. Every human being is a work in progress. And God understands that even you're a work in progress. You might have grown so much now, but there was a time you were just a total, you know, you were just a clown. I don't know if there's anybody here that you have done things you regret in this life. Can I say no need to hold you, because all of us are answer. You probably have done something you do, but some of you have grown beyond that level. Am I correct? You know better now. But imagine if God killed you. That's why, as Christians, we don't pray for enemies to die. We don't do that. The Bible says you should not do that. You know, some people that do that is based on lack of knowledge and fear. If God was answering that prayer and killing everybody's enemies, I hope you realize that there will be no single human being alive on this earth. Some people say if it's their family members that will kill them. It's not even a neighbor. It's their own family member, their cousin, their brother, inside the same house. Some people, it's their husband or their wife that will kill them. Say, Lord, let all my enemies die. You don't hear bagam behind her from bed. The guy fall, die. Because the enemy is right there on the same bed with her. If God was answering that prayer, all of us would be dead. An eye for an eye will make all of us blind. All of us will be blind by now. So that person is a work in progress. You can't make him a permanent enemy, because by the time God is done with him or her, him or her will not be that same person. So you can't hold on to it. But by the time you've already locked in with grief, with hurt, with bitterness, with anger, with malice, with unforgiveness. Meanwhile, the person has changed, but you are still holding on to the unforgiveness, and you are the one losing. The person has even forgotten. You know, some people that even hurt you, they don't even know they hurt you. Hope you are aware. They've moved, they're continuing their own life. You are the one walking about saying, they are forgotten. They don't even know you exist. Somebody getting this? They don't even know you're angry. Somebody came to our house this week. Him and his wife, they sat down and he was gisting how it took long. How when he first came to church, you know, he didn't feel welcome. He did long, many things. He feel he has offended me. I had no clue what he was talking about. No clue. His wife was coming. He was not coming. I thought he traveled, because he was traveling when they were about to. I thought it was I didn't know he was around since. And he thought that I was not happy with him. I said, I have no clue what you're talking about. No clue. So sometimes what you're thinking in your mind, the person doesn't even know you exist. The person doesn't even know you're angry. And the anger is wearing you out, is killing you gradually. You can't keep malice inside you. You were not designed to carry malice. You were not designed to carry hatred. You were not designed to carry pain or hurt. Once you carry those things, you are wearing yourself out. You're shortening your life. Romans 12. We'll round up from here. What should I do when these things happen? We'll start from verse 14. Everything I wanted to say, every solution to it is in this same piece of scripture. Romans 12 from verse 14. Are we there, guys? Okay. It says, do what? Bless them which what? It said, bless and what? So this is the instruction. The reason why you need to do this is that it's important. You can't, the person, you see, if a dog bites you, you can't bite the dog back. You know, most people, because they're so angry, they rather bite the dog, but it doesn't make any sense. If a dog bites you, the dog is doing what is normal to it. When you start biting the dog back, you see, they will just carry you like that to mental home. And that's what most people do. If somebody is playing dirty, it doesn't mean you should come to their level. That's what they actually want. They feel you are high up there. They know that you are operating a higher level of understanding. They would rather you come low to their level. Because when you come low to their level and start fighting with them or arguing with them or quarreling with them, that you are making them, you're actually helping, you're actually fulfilling their dreams. Stop retaliating. That's what the Bible is saying. It's a bless them that persecute you. It's a bless and curse not. Our natural feelings wants to curse back, wants to retaliate. He said, no. He said, bless them which persecute you. He said, bless and curse not. Next verse. He says, do what? Rejoice with them that rejoice, and do what? Weep with them that weep. Very powerful. You know why they say rejoice with them that rejoice? Because if you don't do that, the next option you will have is to be envious of them. That's what that guy did. I slapped that guy. What he should have done was, I believe, finish the race, go and hug that guy and congratulate him for winning. If you don't do that, the only option you have left is to be envious of that person's blessing. Rejoice with people that rejoice. When good things happen to people, rejoice with them. That's the only way the good thing can enter your life. The things you appreciate are the only things that can enter your life. The moment you start being envious of another person, say, why will he have that kind of car? Why will he have those many car? Why will he do this one? Why will he? Rejoice with them that rejoice. It's the only solution. If you don't do that, envy will enter your heart. Second thing they said is, weep with them that what? Weep. Do you know, most times, when bad things happen to people, your natural mind wants to say, hey, I knew it. Olaumu. The guy was too proud before now. Thank God now God don't humble him. Be careful of things like that. Because you don't even know what is coming into your own life. Learn to sympathize with people when they are going through a rough time. Your job, even if things are happening to them so that they can become wiser, it's not your job. You are not the lecturer. Sympathize with them. Weep with them that weep. Don't laugh at them. Don't laugh at people in their time of challenge. Don't laugh at people in their time of challenge. Big mistake. Big temptation. Don't laugh at people. Next line. All the answers are here. Be of what? The same mind one toward another. Mind not high things, but condensate to men of what? Lowest. Don't be the kind of person that feel there's some people you can't relate with. This way, they're not my level. Even though you know you're a leader, even though you know you're a genius, you're operating at a higher level of thinking, the proof of your humility is still that you are able to tolerate people that are operating at a very low or way lower than you. The moment you become impatient, that you stupid, you don't have sense. The moment you become like that, then that becomes pride, and that puts you in danger yourself. Somebody getting this? Most people fall into that kind of temptation. They are right, but they are making a fuss about being right, so they become wrong. I don't know if you get what I'm saying. You have the better decision, the better advice, or the better idea, but just because there's a guy called Ahithophel in the Bible, Ahithophel killed himself. Ahithophel was one of the wisest men that ever lived. The Bible said that if Ahithophel gave you counsel, it was as if God was the one that talked to you. Just go and do it. Ahithophel was that wise. One time, David needed advice or so. He asked Ahithophel. Ahithophel gave him advice. They didn't take Ahithophel's advice. Ahithophel say, Me? He couldn't breathe. Me? And so he died. Ahithophel died because they didn't take his. He was too proud. How wouldn't they take my advice? I'm always right. Don't tell anybody, do you ever have the temptation that you are always right? Does it happen to you sometimes? Don't tell anybody. Does that sickness attack you sometimes? Where you think you are always right? Does it happen to you? To be honest. You know that sickness attacks everybody. Something will just be whispering to you. You know you are always right. You know your view is the only view in this nation. You know it's your way or the highway. That demon whispers to everybody. Only fools listen to that demon. The Bible says, don't be wise in your own conceit. Don't think you are the only one that knows everything. You can't know everything. You can't be right every time. There's no human being like that. So when you start taking people's wrong, personal, you are wrong. You too, you are wrong at times. So relax. Allow them make mistakes. Be patient with people in their mistake. Let's move on quickly. Where did we stop? Yeah. So we say, understand people too. Don't be wise. Condescend to men of lust. Be not wise in your own conceit. Don't think I'm always right. I always know. Once you have that mentality, you will not be open to new things. Next verse. It says, recompense to no man what? Evil for evil. It says, provide things honest in the sight of women. Don't recompense evil for evil. Don't say because they spoke bad about me, because they abused me, I must abuse them. If they go low, we go high. You don't have to get down to their level. Next verse. He said, if it be possible, as much as lieth in you, he said, live peaceably with what? Oh man. As long as it's possible, because sometimes, honestly, it might not be possible. Because he said, as long as it's possible, live at peace with all men. As long as it lies in your power, as long as it lies in your power to let some things go, let them go. Live at peace with all men. Next verse. He said, dearly beloved, he said, do what? Avenge not yourselves. Don't retaliate. You can't retaliate. You are not allowed to retaliate. You are the one that will get the red card. He said, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath. He said, for it is written, vengeance is mine, and I will what? Repay. Say the Lord. The moment you allow God to do the revenging for you, or the fighting for you, he said, I will repay you. With God, you never actually lose. If you leave it for him to sort it out, he will turn that bad that they did to you to something good. He will always do that. That's where many people miss it. Many people revenge for themselves, so they suffer twice. See that goalkeeper now. They hit him once, then he also collected red card. He has suffered twice. That's what revenge does. Revenge makes you suffer twice. But when you allow God, he will repay. He will compensate you. He said, vengeance is mine, said the Lord. I will repay. That's what happened to Joseph. Because he didn't fight back, God turned the bad they did to him to good. And he even told his brothers that what you planned for evil, God turned it for. God used it to bring my destiny to pass. You know that guy that they slapped? As they slapped him, they made him cross the line faster. I don't know if you noticed that in the video. As they slapped him, the slap made him even move faster. The things your enemies are doing to try and hinder you, they will only make you move faster. That's what that will happen. To turn out for good. Next verse. Next verse. It says, therefore, if thy enemy hunger, do what? Feed him. If he thirst, do what? Give him drink. It says, for in so doing, thou shalt heap what? Coals of fire on his head. So when your enemy needs help, help him. Let him go high. Don't let him control your behavior. That's why the Bible says, if they slap you on one cheek, turn the next cheek. They're not saying you should be a fool. What they're saying is that, don't let this guy control your behavior. If you're not going to fight before, then don't fight just because this guy is slapping you. Don't let him dictate what you do. If he dictates what you do, then you have come lower than him because he's now controlling you. Don't let him control you. That's what they're saying. Go back to where we were. It says, next verse 21. It said, be not what? Don't be overcome of evil or by evil, but overcome evil with what? With good. So the next time, is that the last verse on that chapter? Yeah. So the next time somebody treats you badly, treat them nice. It will shock them. I can never forget one day, on social media, I even try not to read comments. If you're a public person, one of the ways to have peace of mind, don't read comments because people are jobless. People are angry about life. They will just bring that anger to somebody's life or somebody's page and be writing rubbish. I see it all the time. Somebody can even put a watch that he bought, any amount. Is his watch? Is his money? Another person, why are you spending such in this? What concern you? People are angry and jobless. So it saves you not to be bothered about what people are saying. You know, safeguard your heart and mind. If you always want to answer everybody that is talking to you, they are going to bring you to their level at the end of the day. That's what they are going to do. So I can never forget one day, I've forgotten what a broadcast I sent, you know, on BlackBerry. I've forgotten what it was about. I think it was about a program or something. And somebody just answered What kind of thing is that? That's why you were always talking. You were just angry. And I was trying to tell him, no, you know. So I was telling him, no, you see, you have two options. You cannot be on my page or my BlackBerry and be talking rubbish. You can remove yourself, but you can't be talking rubbish. The guy to answer back, I gave him back. He answered back, I said, this guy don't know me, I go deal with him. And after I deal with him, I go delete him. Then it just occurred to me, these things just occurred to me that this guy is not angry with you. You see, most time when people are talking to you badly, they are not angry with you, they are just angry. And you just got caught in the crossfire. So the next thing that happened, it just dawned on me that this guy is not angry with me. He's angry about life. So I just turned it around and started talking to him about his business. Because he was talking about that. The business is not. I said, so what's happening in your business? He said, can you imagine? Me and Percy, they blast ourselves now. Say somebody ordered something. The person didn't want to pay. He delivered. I said, we started talking about his life. I started praying for him. You see, if I was not conscious, if the Holy Spirit didn't pinch my heart to listen well, I would have just been fighting him, thinking that the guy was fighting me. He was never fighting me. He delivered something, they didn't pay him. And I think he borrowed money to make the delivery. Are you seeing his problem? He's angry. I wasn't the one. Most times we have self-importance. We think we are the one. This conductor is angry with me. This driver is me. They are against. They are not against you. Some of these guys are frustrated. Some people, we don't know where they live. As it rained yesterday, some people, where they live, as it rained now, they are going to swim out of their room. So imagine somebody that used canoe to come out of his room. Use canoe to come out of the street. Then you just come and park your fine car and block his front. There's no way he's not going to pour the anger on you. But the truth is that he's not really angry with you. He's angry about life. He might be angry about things that are not working for him. So you must be mindful of that. Most people are not angry. It's not personal. They are behaving to the best of their behavior or the best of their knowledge or the best of their experience. They might be going through a hard time. They might be going through insecurities. People have not treated them well. Maybe their parents deserted them. Maybe they don't have good upbringing. They are just, this is the best of their behavior. As a pastor, and I've done this job for 20 years, so I've seen people grow. There are some families that, you know, almost all of them well behaved because it's just the way they were brought up. They are nice, they are loving, they are caring, they are well behaved. You don't need so much maintenance. They are nice people. Some other families, all of them are troublemakers from beginning to the end. It's just their upbringing. If you can't appreciate that, you will think these guys are against you. They're not against you. This is the best of their behavior. You must accommodate them. You must tolerate them. You must understand where they are coming from and also still help them get to where they are going to. You can't say, no, I will fight you back. No. Be patient. People are work in progress. There are people that were my staunch enemies in time past. Today, they are my major friends. Because they were work in progress. They've grown now to understand that I was not against them. That when I was telling them the truth, it was for them to be better. You know, those early days of ministry, now it doesn't happen so much again, but those early days of ministry, when I preach sometimes, some people would just come and say, it was me Pastor was talking about. The things I discussed with Pastor. That's what he was now saying on the stage. Not knowing that most times what one person is going through, usually in a church that is large, many people are going through the same thing. So whether it was your story or not your story, it's benefiting people. As long as your name is not mentioned, relax. Hallelujah. So you must be patient. Hallelujah. Be patient with people. Praise God. Have you been blessed at all today?
Hi there. Can I invite you to church? Any of these Sundays on the mainland, we have service starts for 7:30 a.m. The second service from 9 a.m. The venue is Fagem's bus stop behind the PFCN office at Amoredofin, Lagos. And if you stay anywhere on the island, our service on the island starts for 10 a.m. The venue is right beside Meadow Hall Schools, after third roundabout in Lekki, Lagos. I look forward to seeing you there. You'll be my special guest.